One of the main goals of causality is to understand story as not just a bunch of events, but as events that are connected in some way. In this tutorial, we're talking about events that depend on each other. A setup and a payoff is one example of a dependency. Here, a particular song is playing on the radio. And later, someone references that song. Here, the character looks in a photo album. And at the end, he closes the album to symbolize closure. The purpose of tracking such a dependency is to understand these events as part of the same idea. But it also creates a rule that causality then helps us to not break. To show what I mean, let's move the setup over to just before the payoff. Everything is still happening in the right order. But if I now move the setup to after the payoff, so he closes the photo album before he has opened it, causality gives me an error. If I hover on the red error indicator, it says that him closing the album should be after him looking in it. And if I look on the other beat, it's the same thing, just that it should be before. And if you notice, there's now a red bar in the timeline that also shows the error. This is super helpful because it means that I can just define the rules of the story and then never think about them again. If I mess up, causality will let me know. There are two ways to create dependencies. The first is to alt or option drag a line between them. This only works over short distances. Over long distances, you select one end and choose Create Dependency From in the menu, and this is on the Command or Control I key. And then you select the other end and choose Create Dependency To or Command or Control O. And that's it. And then you can click the little running man icon to fly to the other end. Another common kind of dependency in a story is to plant something before it's needed, so it doesn't just pop out of nowhere. For example, there's a moment in Ghostbusters where Dan Aykroyd gets the idea for the Marshmallow Man. What if we created a scene early on where they're so broke that the only food to eat is a bag of marshmallows they found in a cupboard? Then we'll use Command or Control I to create a dependency from. And then go to the scene where he gets the idea and use Command or Control O to create a dependency to. So we're creating the story in reverse. You start with the thing you want to have happen. And then you go back and touch on it just once before, so it's already part of the story. And then the story feels more interconnected when it happens. Finally, dependencies aren't just between beats. They can be between entire groups or blocks, which is a major reason these exist. Such a connection says that all of the things on the left have to be completed before I'm allowed to move into any of the things on the right. For example, if we're making a bank robbery, we also need to plan the robbery. And we need to steal a getaway car. So I'll use the Alt or Option key to connect both the planning into the robbery and also the stealing of the getaway car. Now both of these have to be complete before we're allowed to move into the robbery or the story doesn't make sense. And then let's look at what happens if I accidentally move one of the planning events to later in the story. Now the error says that the whole planning should go before the bank robbery. This way, you simply define your story's rules and then you don't have to think about them anymore. Causality will let you know if there's a problem. One thing you might not have noticed is that the timeline actually knows about the dependency. When we drag the beat, the timeline darkens any area it would be bad to move the beat into. And if we do it anyway, we get the error. The same goes in the script. If I drag the event with a song place on the radio downwards, the script turns yellow where it would break my rule to drop it. So let's place it on the safe side.